Hi everybody, my name is Eckhard Langer. I am responsible for the laboratories we have on site here on Fab 1 in Dresden. So we do have four analytical labs. So one for materials analysis, one for failure analysis, a lab for chemical analysis, and we do have a lab where we investigate the reliability of our products. So we understand ourselves as a service provider. We provide our services to the fab, to the yield and integration department, to others, and of course also to our customers of GlobalFoundries. Today we have a chance to give you a tour per video through these labs, and I'd like to invite you, please be welcome to our labs to see what we do as our daily job.
The Materials Analysis Lab supports technology development and manufacturing with advanced analytical services. Electron microscopy, surface spectroscopy, and other physical analysis techniques are used to investigate material properties, such as feature sizes, chemical compositions, and mechanical strength. Such lab-based techniques can provide additional insights that in-fab metrology methods cannot deliver. The technicians and engineers are highly skilled in sample preparation and analysis workflows. With expertise in process technology and material science, they serve as consultants for the process and integration engineers, and help to interpret results and draw conclusions from them. What is especially fascinating is that we can actually touch the wafers and look directly into the chips. Focused ion beam instruments are used to create cross-sections of the smallest structures on the chips. With electron microscopy, we can achieve the highest magnifications, looking at individual atoms if needed. Surface spectroscopy analysis can detect concentrations of chemical elements like germanium, boron, or iron as low as 1 in 1 billion atoms. The toughness of the back-end stack against crack generation and evolution is also measured with dedicated mechanical test methods. Welcome to the Physical Failure Analysis Team. Our team supports several analytical methods that help investigate yield issues related to fab or customer issues. If we get analysis requests for wafers or chips and we don't know the exact position of the failure, we need to localize them first. This is done by using methods like photon emission, thermal emission, or Oberth. We use wet and plasma chemical processes to remove layers, but also a full wafer polisher for controlled thinning of the wafer. Another self-invented and useful tool is the wafer beamer. It is used to project defect or yield wafer maps directly onto the wafer to mark dyes or areas more easily. For our nanoprobing, we need to break a small piece out of the wafer. To get to the layer of interest, the chips must be thinned or ground down. For this, we use a small polishing tool with polishing cloth and a diamond polish suspension. In the next step, we nanoprobe the devices. With the support of the layout, we can very precisely follow the preparation process and precisely document the failure and its location. Welcome to the Chem Lab. In this lab, we support mainly the production and facilities departments with various and short-term chemical analysis. One main focus is to check the cleanliness of the chemicals and tools used for the process. After sample preparation, the chemicals are checked with our very sensitive ICP-MS mass spectrometers for contamination in the parts per trillion concentration range, which means a nanogram per liter concentration. The chemicals are mainly hazardous, so special safety equipment has to be used in many process steps. For the contamination monitoring of production tools, test wafers are processed in these tools and afterwards analyzed in the chem lab for surface contamination with the VPD-ICP-MS process. Initially, the wafer is etched with HF vapor, and then the wafer surface is extracted by a droplet of a diluted acid. After dilution, this droplet is measured by ICP-MS in PPT concentration range. Another task in the chem lab is the determination of assay of the process chemicals and the composition of process mixtures, like cleaning and electroplating baths. Here, among other things, the assay determination of hydrogen peroxide is shown. In addition, many other analytical techniques are used to support the production process, like microbiology, which plays an important role to assess the quality of our ultra-pure water and of certain chemicals. Another laboratory is the Reliability Lab. Here, current and future technologies are tested for their lifetime requirements. To accelerate aging, transistors are operated with increased operating voltage at a higher temperature. The measurement of the parameters results in so-called degradation curves, which are evaluated by reliability engineers. Ready processed wafers are measured in the laboratory, and a prober is required to carry out the measurements. The prober brings the wafer to a defined temperature, can position it with micrometer precision, and place the needles on the measurement structures. Parameter analyzers are used for the measurement. These can measure very low currents and show the progress of the parameters over time. The test software controls all tools involved and creates the log files. In this way, methods such as hot carrier injection, HCI, time-dependent dielectric breakdown, TDDB, and bias temperature instability, BTI, provide information on how reliably a product will function over several years. In addition to measurements on wafers, it is necessary to test the structures in packages using methods such as electromigration, EM. For this, the lab in Fab1 relies on the support of the assembly line of the BTF. Electromigration stresses the back end of our technologies, specifically the metal lines that are applied to the wafer to contact the circuits. In this context, stress means high currents and high temperatures over a comparatively long time. Several days to weeks. The employees of the Reliability Lab provide important information right at the start of technology development. They accompany technologies over several milestones. However, regular measurements are continued even after qualification. This monitoring is part of the reports for our customers. In addition, statements on reliability are required for MRBs and PCRBs.